to preach at his church, and at the close of that number of services that Charles Spurgeon wrote, I mean, preached, the people were leaving the church saying, "Oh, what a preacher." Another very humble preacher came, preached another series of messages, and as those church folks were leaving, they were saying, "Oh, what a Savior." It's not about the preacher, it's not about the church, it's about the Savior that we serve.
Amen.
Well, this morning I get the privilege of doing something that it's one of the greatest things that I get to do. Is I get to dedicate a little baby this morning, so Kevin and Brandy will come. I'm going to dedicate a little Noah. Whenever it comes time to dedicate a little one, we choose to dedicate rather than baptize. Many biblical faiths baptize, but we're going to dedicate a little Noah. By the way, who's bigger, you or him? You might doubt. Yeah. He's a little bigger, yeah. But anyway, when we come to this occasion, it brings back to memory a lot of the things that we teach in our class of what Nazarenes believe. So I'm going to touch on a few of those things this morning as we dedicate a little more this morning. But first of all, what I want to do is I want to show you that I've got these two roses. One is a white rose, and this rose represents innocence. It represents the way that little Noah came into this world. Even though Noah is part of a fallen race that you and I are also a part of, he still was born in innocence. And so this morning, this rose represents that innocence, and we want to dedicate him with this rose. If you would come on over here, Kevin. There you go. But then there's coming a time, Kevin, when this little one is going to grow up and realize that he is a part of Adam's race. And that even though he was born innocent, he was born a sinner, just like every person in the sanctuary. Doesn't matter whether you were born and raised in the church, or you were born and raised by godly parents, you were born into this race as a sinner. And that requires that each of us have a Savior. And I have good news. Jesus came into this world to be our Savior. And as a Savior, he died on a cross, Mary, for our sins. But more important than this morning, he died for Noah's sins as well. And so this morning, there's going to come a time when little Noah is going to grow up. He's going to come to Sunday school. He's going to be a part of church. He's going to go to children's church. And then, at some point, there's going to be a time when he's either in Sunday school or he's in the church in the sanctuary. And there's going to come this thought to his mind that he's broken the heart of God with his sin. And then he needs Jesus to stand between him and God. And Jesus bridged the gap between us and the God that created us. And little Noah needs a Savior. And so this morning, in this act of dedication, we know what Jesus would do. This red rose represents the blood of Jesus Christ. And so we dedicate little Noah with this red rose. But you see, we're not counting on little Noah finding out all by himself. We're counting on you two. God is counting on you two to bring him to the house of the Lord, to teach him, to read him the Bible, to let the Word of God be a very big part of his growing up years. There are many of us here this morning. It wasn't our heart of our lives. It wasn't until I was 16 years old that I understood really that the Bible was written to me. We can't let that happen, anymore. And so this morning, this act of dedication is your promise to raise him in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord, to keep him in church, to be faithful, to teach him the Bible. Are you up for that? that challenge today? Well, I have good news for you today. You're not in this by yourself. If you would, as a congregation, would you stand? This morning I ask this congregation, the First Church of the Nazarene in Shelbyville, Tennessee, will you pledge to do your very best to support this couple in this endeavor of raising this child in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord? If you promise to do that, would you say, I do?
I do.
Thank you. You're all married now. If you would, I'm going to place this Bible right here. This is my preaching Bible. And I want you to kneel in front of this Bible. Now this morning, this is an act of dedication that is between these two people, between Kevin Rogers and Randy Rogers. And they vowed this morning to do their very best to raise this child. But they've allowed you to be a part of the scene. So I want you, as we present Noah, Zane, Rogers, in dedication, would you bow your hearts and your heads? Heavenly Father, I thank you for this occasion. I thank you for Kevin. I thank you for Brandon. Father, you know their lives. You know who they are. You know what they do. They come this morning on this Sunday morning to make a pledge, offer a vow, that this child you've given to them, perfect in every way, Lord, that you will use them to bring this child up in the knowledge and the nurture and the admonition of the God they serve. Father, this is not for the faint of heart. This is not for the wishy-washy. These are very serious vows. But this morning, right here before God, before this great cloud of witnesses, they come to say, yes, Lord, little Noah is yours. We pray that you would take him, and that through the years, Lord, you will have your hand upon him. And that, Lord, who knows how and when you will use him, but we know you will. And so, Father, this couple needs your help. Oh, they need your help. Lord, there'll be days, Lord, when they won't know what to do. Just like all of the rest of us parents that are here this morning. Oh, there were times we didn't know which direction to turn. We didn't know what to do next. We didn't know how to correct. We didn't know how to love. But Lord, you slipped in next to us. And you helped us. You guided us. You directed us. You were there when we didn't have any other place to turn. And so Lord, we know that you'll do the same for Kevin and Brandon. And so today, right here, in this moment, we dedicate little Noah Zane Rogers in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So just in case, we always do this, we always have a Bible to give you, in case you don't already have one, but I know you do. And then this is a little certificate that says, this is what we did on this day. And I hope that one of these days you'll be able to show him that. And he'll be able to know what happened this day has changed his life. Okay? Take care of the stuff. Let's give them a hand.